Here tonight, neighbors in Huntersville are talking about the same strange sound they've heard multiple times this week. Listen.
Kind of creepy, right? That's a Ring camera video neighbor Ryan Beard posted on YouTube capturing the mysterious sound. And get this, he said he was just sitting in his living room Tuesday night watching TV when all of a sudden he heard that growling sound.
And since then, neighbors say they're hearing something similar across the area.
And Will, a lot of people tell you that they've never heard anything like this.
When he heard that heavy humming echoing through his home, when Beard posted the video on Nextdoor, he heard from another neighbor this morning who said they heard the same sound.
Is it a boat, a plane, possibly a UFO? Well, people living in the Highland Creek area of North Charlotte say whatever it is, they want it to stop. The mysterious and loud hum happened 2 days ago, and then again just after 4 this morning.
Folks living in a Northwest OKC neighborhood aren't getting much sleep this week.
The reason: random loud booms heard at night, also during the day. Our Tevis Hillis is looking into the mystery that is baffling homeowners and the city.
I haven't quite heard that sound, but homeowners tell me that this sound is shaking their walls. It's waking their kids up throughout the night and also driving their animals crazy.
150 was the first one. It was back to back, probably about 30 seconds apart. And then this morning at 5:15.
Like a log falling into like a commercial trash can. It sounds like this.
Quail Creek, a calm, quiet community, but for the last week, they've all been asking, have you heard it?
People over here telling them about what was going on. They thought we were crazy, and then all of a sudden it went off.
Yeah, we heard it two or three times last night. I heard dogs barking. I've got bags under my eyes from staying up, you know.
The sound is going off at all times of the day, randomly. Now it'll last about 30 seconds, but goes off multiple times.
We have a mystery on our hands, and we're not sure where it's coming from.
The city getting involved. They've sent out the utilities department, flushed the lines, checked sewers, looked at a geological survey, spoke with the golf course, talked with ONG. They have no answers.
But some say they've heard it for the past 2 months. Others are just hearing it this week.
All right, top of some breaking news just into the Fox 5 newsroom. The mystery of the countywide booms that have been rattling San Diegans for a couple days here continues.
Here we go again.
There were two distinct episodes with windows shaking. The first one was two very abrupt, pretty violent shakes that I would say were maybe 10 seconds each. And then I went, wow, that feels like an earthquake. Mom and Dad, you think that's an earthquake?
But the U.S. Geological Survey didn't report any earthquakes near San Diego today. So some people think they heard explosions from military bases.
Fire!
The Marine Corps base at Camp Pendleton tells ABC 10 News they cannot confirm the exact noise or shaking.
Residents we talked to say they typically just chalk up odd noises to military activity, but say this one this morning was much different than what they typically hear and feel in Mira Mesa.
We were just having breakfast, and there was two different booms that came, but the first time we just heard, for me it sounded like someone was knocking on our windows at the side of the house. It was really strange. Went and looked, nothing, thought maybe it was the wind. So then about 2 minutes later, another one, like twice the size of that, just came, and it just was rattling the whole side of the house. Everything was just rattling for maybe 3 or 4 seconds. It was just odd. It felt like an earthquake, but it just went so fast. We knew it wasn't an earthquake.
Here's some people taking it to Twitter right away. Just about a half hour ago, they said, yet another strange jolt just rattled our neighborhood in San Diego.
We have it from time to time, and a lot of people wondering what the heck's going on.
A lot of things going on.
And heard the two huge booms that night and rushed out her back door.
No smoke, nothing at all. It just seemed unusual, very, very unusual. It was horrifying. I mean, I was scared to death. And I looked out my shade out onto the golf course thinking that I'd see an explosion or something out there.
But instead of an explosion, Dawn caught these photos of brightness in the sky. Wednesday, while speaking with her, North Kingstown canine units scoured the area to uncover what is disrupting the town.
My friends and neighbors here are pretty afraid. Not knowing, like, if something happened and what it was. I mean, I think the biggest thing is what it was. like, what was it? If we saw something, maybe that would explain what it was, but there's no explanation.
Multiple reports of explosions in the area, and tonight we're learning this isn't the first time. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Tiffany Murphy.
And I'm John DeLuca. North Kingstown residents have been complaining of hearing large booms and explosions that up until this point, no one can really put their finger on where they're coming from or what they're all about.
Residents that I spoke to today have been reporting for the last couple of weeks now, which have quite literally shaken this community. North Kingstown police also told me that similar reports have come out of neighboring towns like East Greenwich and
Ferris's 3-year-old son has been spooked by the constant bangs.
He's asking, like, what was that? And I'm obviously looking like I don't know what it is. And I just tell him, oh, that was some thunder. And he's like, but it's not raining. There is something weird going on.
We begin with a series of loud explosions caught on camera across the San Gabriel Valley last night.
But whatever it was remains a mystery tonight.
But all over the San Gabriel Valley. Others say they actually shook their homes, but so far no one out there is taking credit for causing them. Daniel Rosinos caught it on his security camera. A bright flash in the middle of three loud blasts. We called police and fire departments, city managers, electric and gas companies all over the place, and none of them seemed to know what caused these mysterious explosions that lit up the night sky at about 10:30 Monday night.
Okay, you heard that. Draper police are asking for your help investigating that explosion early Saturday morning on Traverse Mountain. It shook homes and woke up residents on the south end of the Salt Lake Valley. Reports of a mysterious boom in Draper early this morning. According to Draper City, a sound echoed in Salt Lake County around 1 a.m. Police reportedly sped to the scene but found nothing out of the ordinary at first. Today, Draper Police and Salt Lake County's bomb squad scoped out the area a second time after a hiker reported finding evidence of a possible explosion. We spoke to a Draper resident who witnessed it all.
Notice a large flash go off, which is atypical. I've lived in the neighborhood for a few years. And after I saw the flash, I got out of bed and looked up the hill and then heard a boom.
Ian Gillespie says he noticed a smoke plume in the air shortly after and that this event left him and his neighbors unsettled. City officials have confirmed the explosion was not related to any Geneva Rock Mine or Rocky Mountain Power operations. Draper City says there's no threat to the public, but do ask that people stay out of the area.
We know based on what we found that this is not Geneva's doing. We did find evidence of an explosion. There were a lot of people that were speculating that this might have been space debris or a comet, and we've ruled that out.
Very strange. Some of Beard's post, or some on his post, say that the sound is eerily similar to something out of a War of Worlds. Our chief meteorologist Brad Panovich thought it could be Duke Energy conducting an early growl test of its sirens. However, tonight we found out the utility officials reached out to Ryan saying it wasn't them. Colonial Pipeline also says it wasn't doing any work at that time that would warrant that sound, so the mystery remains.